Hi everyone, and welcome to my EKS upgrade guide to version 1.22. Now, this version is a very, very dangerous one because there are multiple removed APIs, not deprecated, removed APIs, like the ingress controller API, which actually requires you to perform YAML structure changes. So in this guide, we'll go over how to scan your production cluster and make sure that you don't have any of those removed beta APIs running, so you will be able to fix it. Then how to upgrade your control plane to version 1.22. And finally, how to upgrade your node groups to the latest version. That is, of course, unless you're using Fargate, because I use Fargate mostly and I don't need it. Okay, so let's get started with the upgrade. So as you can see, I have a cluster here. It is running version 1.21. I have node groups, I have different resources running on it. And the first question that I want to ask myself is, am I running any deprecated beta APIs, things that are going to be removed and that are not going to be able to run on the cluster again after the upgrade? So first of all, there is a great blog post in the official Kubernetes blog that I will link. And there's also a very nice one that I liked by Sysdig that actually talks about, you know, this is a major upgrade, and there's a nice tweet by Kat talking about those five in particular APIs, that including the ingress one, that are very, very major and are very widely used. So first of all, what I want to do is I want to look at an example. So here's an example of an API version v1 beta 1 of the networking API for a kind of ingress. And this is going to be removed. It is now deprecated, but it's going to be removed. And now I want to scan my cluster and to see whether there are additional resources like that that are not going to work. So in order to do that, I'm going to use a tool called Datree and a kubectl integration. And what this tool is going to do, it is going to scan my cluster, extract all of the YAMLs that are running on it, and check whether they are compatible to the schema version of my future cluster's version. So all I have to do is install it. It is very general, using Crew, which is a kubectl plugin manager. And then we're able to run the kubectl Datree plugin. So in order to do so, I'm going to use this command. So kubectl Datree test. And then I'm going to specify the target version. So AWS chose the version 1.22.6 for the clusters. And I'm going to scan this namespace, HN up. Now, what you're going to see happen is that this kubectl is directed into the cluster that I showed you. So it is going to pull all of the YAML manifests and scan them, whether the YAML is valid, whether the schema is correct, and whether they are according to our policy. So let's look at what we got. So the plugin extracted this ingress controller YAML, and it is saw that the YAML itself is valid as expected, but the Kubernetes schema validation failed because it could not find a correct schema for the kind of ingress, because it is correct, we are running a removed one for this version. So it did not even continue to perform a policy check. Now, in addition, it pulled other resources, which are like deployments, and it ran a policy check that the tree provides. So it scanned for it, whether we have the latest image, whether we have liveness probe, readiness probe, all those good stuff. Be sure to check it out. So now we need to ask ourselves, okay, so we identified some problematic resources. What are we supposed to do with them now? So the next thing to do is to read an API deprecation guide and how to do a migration. So the best way that they recommend is to actually use yet another kubectl plugin, which is the kubectl convert plugin. And what it is able to do is you provide it with an old version and it will output the new version for you. So it is really neat. So we have our file here that it is, as you can see, v1 beta, and it is deprecated. So after I've installed the kubectl plugin, I'm going to run it. So let's see what I'm going to do. So kubectl convert, giving it the file, and I'm asking for an output version that actually has the V1 non-beta controller. And it finished and it wrote a new file. So let's look at it. And as you can see, the new one is using the V1 networking API. And you will notice that there is a difference here because it actually requires a YAML change. So here, the backend service has another tick and it says service name and port. And in the old one, it actually used the one name, service name and service port. And the new one is actually using service, and underneath it, it has a name and port. So this way, we can actually find and generate a converted new file and submit it and send it to our cluster in order to update our deprecated APIs. Okay, so let's start the upgrade sequence. I'm going to do two options. So the first one, I'm going to use the GUI, just the console, for the control plane and for the cluster nodes. And the second one, I'm going to use the CLI using EKS Cattle, which is a very nice utility that is actually in the official docs of AWS. So I'm going to my cluster view. AWS is telling me, hey, your Kubernetes version is out of date. I'm going to tell it, update it now. And basically now it starts the upgrade process. So it takes about 10 minutes. And once it will be finished, I will show you the results of how it looks like and how to proceed with the node upgrade. Okay, so our cluster has finished our upgrade. And as you can see, our Kubernetes version is now 1.22. And now the next thing that you have to do is, as AWS is telling us, the AMI release version is still old. And as you can see, it's 1.21. So you can just click on update now. You can tell it whether you want to force upgrade or rolling upgrade. Of course, rolling upgrade, you need your containers to gracefully shut down and then it will perform the upgrade. I'm just going to do force because it's just a demo one to show you. And it will start the upgrade. So we can go into the node group, look at the nodes, and now it will start. I'll just move myself here. And now it will start the upgrade sequence. So basically it should spawn new ones and upgrade them to the newest AMI, which should have enhanced features and also be upgraded to the latest Kubernetes version. So this is how you upgrade your control plane and your cluster node versions. Now let's do it using the EKS Cattle CLI utility. Okay, so now that we finished the upgrading process using the GUI, let's do it using the CLI. So I have yet another cluster that we have to upgrade now. So let's copy it, and I'm going to use the EKS Cattle utility, which is a great utility that I use a lot of the times to spin up clusters or Terraform. So in order to do so, we're going to use the EKS Cattle upgrade cluster command. Now, we're going to specify the region, US East 1, and then we're going to specify the name of the cluster, and we're going to let it run. And it fails because we need to approve it because it's a big change. Great. That's it. So now we've scheduled an upgrade from version 1.21 to 1.22. Let's upgrade and let's go back. And as you can see, it should register as updating in just a few seconds. The control plane sometimes takes a moment to process the request here. And now it is in the updating state. Okay, so as you can see, it took some time, like about 10 minutes, and now it says that our control plane has finished upgrading. So let's go and see. So when we update, we can see that it is in version 1.22, like we wanted. So the next thing is we have a node group that we need to upgrade, and it is in the old AMI version. So again, I can use EKS Cattle upgrade. And now you will see that I can use the node group version of the upgrade. So node group upgrade. And now all I have to do is I have to give it the name of the node group. So I have it here. And I have to give it the cluster name, which I have here. And region, cluster name, node name, group. And again, I'm going to use force upgrade. Obviously, you should use a rolled upgrade for actual production workloads and have a graceful shutdown, which is a whole topic we can do a video on how to do it correctly. So let's see if our upgrade is being registered. And as we can see, it is now updating. So as you can see, it finished upgrading the node group. It did not take so much time as the control plane itself. Let's look at it, and now it is upgraded. So now we have a running cluster running version 1.22. We have a node group running version 1.22. And the final thing that I want to show you is now, you know, you want to prevent misconfigurations from reaching production in Kubernetes workloads. So you might want to run a Datree test every time you build or change your Kubernetes manifests, whether it is using our VS Code add-on, whether it is a pre-commit hook or in your CI/CD. So the final thing that we can do is we can go to the Datree platform, and besides changing the policies and playing with them, we want to change the default server version to the new one, because now we have a shiny new cluster. So I'm going to set the default version of the Datree test into 122.6, and now every time that I run a Datree test check, it will run using this version. And then in the history, you can go and see the schema validation of the version that I prefer. So to sum up, we reviewed how to actually scan your existing clusters to check whether you're using any of the beta APIs that are going to be removed. We then performed an upgrade to our control plane and to our node groups. So be sure to check the links below. I will link the deprecation list in the release notes of the version 1.22 for Kubernetes, the Datree scanner that allows you to scan it, and the kubectl convert plugin that allows you to convert files to meet the new versions. Thank you very much for watching.